Welcome to What It Takes to Create Season 1 Episode 3, and this is going to be my first collab with a very close person of mine who is also a digital media marketer, an engineer, an influencer, and also was my first boss, and his name is Shayan Chapui. So Shayanda, would you please like to introduce yourself?
Hey everyone, welcome to the Tyrant Podcast, and my name is Shayan Chapui. As I like to introduce myself, I am an engineer by degree, a marketer by profession, and a creator by heart. I am a digital marketer. I work with a lot of brands, and my core competency is possibly influencer marketing right now because I work closely with creators. If you're listening to this, just keep listening because a lot of value is packed right here.
All right, Shayanda, so welcome to my podcast, and I would like to ask you this. That is, I have not seen a lot of people who are doing this well in this digital media domain like you are doing, and you have worked with lots of international, national brands, influencers, national influencers, as well as international influencers like Matt Javitt, and lots of companies, and you are working with a Russian company too. So just tell me, how have you become so much interested in this digital media domain? Like, how did you start it? Why do you actually love this?
Okay, so the reason I love digital marketing so much is because I truly, from my core, love marketing. So right from the beginning of my life, I was very, very interested into marketing, about how consumer psychology works, how businesses operate, why the ads are being run like this, why an ad is a certain way, and who is it targeting. So all that, I was very, very intrigued, and I guess life has come to a way where even after being an engineer, it got me a way to become a marketer through digital marketing. So I am more interested into marketing in as a whole, but digital marketing paved the way for me to get better at it and understand the marketing world better, because right now in 2020, digital marketing is marketing.
So what do you think? What could be the biggest asset one can have while building its maybe its personal branding, or doing social media marketing, or something else regarding the social media world?
I think the biggest asset one can possess to create a personal brand is to be really great at communication. What most people get wrong is they get into the technical part of it, but they don't understand that at the core of it, whatever you're trying to bring value to, or whatever kind of personal brand you want to create, be it dancing, be it speaking, be it anything in the world, you need to communicate very well. So communication, the power of communication, the communication skill comes at the top. And it's not just your speaking skills, but it's about how you process the thoughts in your brain. It's about how you write a script. It's about what is the story you're going to tell, all that. So as a personal brand, you need to really, really focus on your communication skills.
So how can a beginner, like absolute beginner like me, can utilize the power of social media and create its personal brand through digital media content?
Okay, this is a question that I get asked a lot, and I feel my answer hasn't changed in the last 2 years, is that don't join a course. Just don't join a course. I am not saying that courses are bad, but don't join a course. Hear me out. I have always been a very, very strong supporter of the fact that you need to learn by practically handling things. Now, how do you start by doing digital marketing? You do it by creating a page. Just create any page on social media. I don't care what it is about. It can be a personal brand. It can be your pets page. It can be a cooking page. It can be a motivational quotes page. I don't care. Just go and create it and start putting content on it. When you do that, you will read a few more things about content marketing, about social media marketing, and you'll understand how things work better. 2 years down the line or 1 year down the line, you'll understand how it works practically. Then if you want to join a course to get polished in a few areas, or join a course and do practical hard work simultaneously. If you just join a course and you don't do stuff practically, it won't be of any help, because digital marketing is a world that changes every single month. So a new thing or a new content genre or a new content format might just come up. So just go ahead and create a page, and that is how you get started with digital marketing.
So what are some platforms we beginners can use, and we can create our own digital media contents which is relevant to the platform as well as our audiences? So how can we do that?
Well, the best platforms right now have to be TikTok and LinkedIn. Now, I know most people will be like, no, TikTok, no. Of course, you guys have not understood the correct potential of TikTok and the whole model of lip syncing and giving expressions to songs. That is a very limited functionality of TikTok. You can use TikTok in so many ways to create so many small micro content and micro stories, and it can change your whole life. So if you are not born for the big YouTube game, if you don't think that you can support a YouTube channel of long form content, just go on TikTok and just explore for about 2 to 3 days about what kind of content is being created over there, and follow international content creators on TikTok like Logan Paul, like David Dobrik, and understand how they are utilizing it. So you can really do anything on TikTok, and yeah, that has to be one like my top social media to create on right now. Another one is LinkedIn, though a little more professional. I think LinkedIn is a place where you share your learnings and your knowledge. It's not really for entertainment. If you can add a little bit of entertaining stuff to your value adding posts, but at the end of the day, it's a professional LinkedIn, professionals social network. So just go ahead and create on it and share your professional knowledge, share your stuff, whatever you're doing, and people will come. That is how you create content, and those are the platforms I recommend.
So now just give us 2 lines about each and every platforms you think which might be relevant to beginners like us, or maybe some intermediate, or maybe experts, and how can they create contents based on those platforms.
Okay, 2 lines on each. One, TikTok. Don't just get stopped on the lip syncing model. Just go and see what other creators worldwide are doing. You will find a format very, very relevant to you, which is a Vine format. So just go ahead and just understand how it works. 2, LinkedIn, professional. Go professional, add value. I don't care that much if you are just creating professional content, but create value-adding content. What do you mean? What do I mean by value adding? Just go ahead and create something that adds a value to someone. So maybe you're into marketing, or maybe you're into cooking. Just add something, add a learning that you can tie to a professional learning. So let's say if you added salt a little bit more in some kind of a dish that you're preparing, it, no matter how good it was originally, it will not be good and not be as good. So what you can put this analogy to professional content is that you can tell people that this is how life is, and if you put something in excess which does not belong there, the whole life will possibly be not as good or as enjoyable. Okay, 3, Instagram. Instagram is all about glamour. Instagram is all about show off. Instagram, most people like to show off their not just professional, but whatever they have gained or some kind of a vanity metric. So just go ahead and create something that people will find interesting. But again, What I truly believe is keep it real on Instagram. Keep yourself real. Don't go for vanity metrics. Go create something that you think will tell a story to a lot of people and they will understand what you are. Don't just try to be all cool and all funny and all very positive on Instagram.
What about YouTube or Vimeo, like the mainly video streaming platforms?
For YouTube, think of YouTube like a cable channel, like a TV channel. That is why it's called like a YouTube channel, okay? People come to see your content regularly. Most people on YouTube don't want to see just one content from one person. They subscribe only after, let's say, having watched 2 to 3 videos. Most people I know. So what you do on YouTube is you try to create a loyal subscriber base on YouTube. So put out content regularly, put out interesting content. You don't have to rush through the content, but make sure that whatever you're telling a story, at the end of the day, everything is about telling a story. So whatever you're telling, if it's a learning video, if it's a vlog, if it's an interview, just go long form, but don't go too long form so that people feel that they are losing out on watching something else at that moment.
So number 5 is about Facebook, and what's your take on this declining of this organic reach in Facebook, and how can you use that?
Number 5 is Facebook. Facebook is a very tricky option. I would prefer to keep your Facebook very, very personal. And that tip, since you're using all the other social media to basically become a creator, right now, since Facebook is not really helping too much as for creators, I think just keep it personal. Keep it very, very loyal to a few people. Don't go around sending people or too many people friend requests. Just keep it personal. That is where your personal thing belongs. That is where you connect to the people who are relevant to you, who are not really your fans, but friends.
And finally, we are going to wrap up with this question is, you have to give us one tip to the beginners like us who wants to create more, but can't because we are afraid too much about others' judgment.
I think the one and only thing you need to understand to keep creating more and forget the judgment is to understand that you are not special. You are not. No matter how many people you think that are judging you, they are not. Maybe for the moment they will, and they will forget. So do the simple exercise that might help you, is that try to remember something very, very embarrassing or anything that you have done in the last 6 months. Okay, you will be able to. Now try to remember something very embarrassing someone else has done. It's very much possible that you are not being able to. So that is how you understand that most people will not be able to remember what you did 6 months down the line, what anything embarrassing or anything you did. So don't get caught up, because at the end of the day, this is not that valuable to you. Just go create, and that is how you become a personal brand 6 months down the line. Just forget about the judgment, because judgment does not really exist a few days later. And even if they do, it shouldn't make you stop. I mean, take the biggest of the people. All their haters hated them, judged them. But once you start showing results, they will be the ones who congratulate you.
So thank you, Shanda. Thank you for this these questions and these valuable insights, and I'll see you guys in the next episode.